Hello everyone, I am Divarani Pandurang Babar, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS IOIT Pune. Let's discuss part 2 of SAIT identities. We will continue our discussion on SAIT identities in this particular presentation. So here, first law is complementation laws. A complement, that means double complement of A is nothing but A. Now we know that double complement of A is nothing but the set of X is such that X does not belongs to A complement. So A does not belongs to A complement is nothing but the negation of X belongs to A complement. Afterwards, negation of X belongs to A complement is nothing but the negation of X does not belongs to A. So double negation of X belongs to A is nothing but X belongs to A. That means A complement is nothing but the values of all x is such that x belongs to A. So final result will be double complement of A is nothing but A. This is the complementation law. Next one is what? Commutative laws. So there are two laws. First one is A union B is equal to B union A. And second one is A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. Now see the first law, A union B. Now we know that what is A union B? A union B is equal to the all values of X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. We can written this definition as X belongs to B or X belongs to A also, so that A union B is equal to B union A. Now, second commutative law is A intersection B is equal to the value of all X is such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. Now, here also we can replace X belongs to A and X belongs to B by X belongs to B and X belongs to A. So that we can say that A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. So this is all about the commutative laws. Now next one is associative laws. See the first associative law. A union B union C is equal to A union B union C. And second associative law is A intersection B intersection C is equal to A intersection B intersection C. Now, first we will see this associative law. Now, see A union B union C. Now, we know the definition of A union B. So we can write here the all values of X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B or X belongs to C. Now we have already studied what are the law of logical equivalences. So we know this law, that is P or Q or R, where Q or R within brackets is equal to P or Q or R, where P or Q are within brackets. So according to this law of logical equivalence, we can write A union B union C is equal to X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B, and outside the bracket or X belongs to C. So according to this, answer will be A union B union C, where A union B within the brackets. Now, second associative law, A intersection B intersection C. Now, we know the definition of A intersection B. According to that definition, we can write all the values of X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B and X belongs to C. So, by second associative law of logical equivalence, that is P and Q and R, where Q and R within bracket is equal to P and Q and R, where P and Q are within bracket. According to this law of logical equivalence, we can write A intersection B intersection C is equal to the value of X is such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B, and outside the bracket and X belongs to C. So we can write this statement as A intersection B intersection C, where A intersection B within bracket. Now, next one is distributive laws. So first distributive law is A intersection B union C is nothing but A intersection B union A intersection C. And second distributive law is A union B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection A union C. Now, we will first see first distributive law, that is A intersection B union C. Now, we know the definition for A intersection B. According to this definition, we can write the values of all X is such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B union C. Now, we can write X belongs to B union C as X belongs to B or X belongs to C. Now, from the rule of logic, P and Q or R is equal to P and Q, or in second bracket P and R. According to this rule, we can write the values of all X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B, or X belongs to A and X belongs to C. Now, X belongs to A and X belongs to B is nothing but X belongs to A intersection B, and X belongs to A and X belongs to C is nothing but A intersection C. So that from this statement, we can write A intersection B union A intersection C. Thus, first law proved. Now, second distributive law is A union B intersection C. Now, here we know the definition of A union B. So, according to this definition, we can write X is such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B and X belongs to C. Now, same from the rule of logic, P or Q and R is equal to P or Q and P or R. According to this rule, we can write X is such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B, and X belongs to A or X belongs to C. Now, we know that X belongs to A or X belongs to B is nothing but X belongs to A union B, and X belongs to A or X belongs to C is nothing but X belongs to A union C. So, afterwards, we can write A union B intersection C is exactly equal to, in the first bracket, A union B intersection, in the second bracket, A union C. Thank you.